about it, ladies and gentlemen. Yes, you might wake up tomorrow morning. You might die tomorrow morning. You might be alive tonight. Yes, you don't know, actually. You have no control over your life. Yet there is nothing. The Bible says, the Bible shows that man has no promise tomorrow. Our life is like a vapor. It is just there for a minute and it fades away. Our life is there for a second and we pass away. Yes, how many lifetimes you got in this world? 70 years, 80 years. How much lifetime you got in this world? Tell me. Tell me. If you can number the days of your life, if you can clearly say it is determined to live for me 120 years, you may raise your hand and say it. But there is no chance. No, there's no one doctor, no one physician. Yes, there's nobody who can promise you tomorrow. Yes, there's nobody who can give you existence tomorrow, ladies and gentlemen. No man among, and nobody under heaven among man can give you a tomorrow. But the Bible said there is a name. There's a name given in the kingdom of man. There's a name given among man under heaven by which we must be saved, the Bible says. And his name is Jesus Christ, ladies and gentlemen. There is a God. There is a God who can give promise tomorrow. There is a God who can influence tomorrow. There is a God who can protect tomorrow. Yes, ladies and gentlemen. There is a God who can move. He knows what tomorrow is going to come. Yes, he knows what the day will bear. Ladies and gentlemen. Yes, there is a God. And he's love. Yes, that's why I would ask you today to ask Jesus into your life.
Yes.
Yes, add the Lord into your life.
Yes.
If you want security, don't run to the mortgage. If you want security, don't go to the stock market, ladies and gentlemen, because you won't find security there. The Bible says, cursed is the man that trusts in man. Yes, cursed is the man. If your neighbors, if your friend is your surety, cursed are you, I tell you, because your friend has no promise tomorrow. You don't have any promise tomorrow. I don't have any promise tomorrow. But Jesus Christ is the only promise for tomorrow.
Amen.
The only valid promise for tomorrow. A promise which will never disappoint. A promise which can never be revoked. A promise which can never be reproved. Yes, ladies and gentlemen. A promise which is everlasting. I was reading something yesterday on the internet. And somebody was searching for the definition of truth. And you might think the definition of truth is that the clarity and the essence of something unveiled without a lie. The absence of lie for us is truth. But actually, we are just defining the term. But it is not literally what truth is. And a man was searching for what is truth. And he was searching and he checked in the Greek. In the Greek, they were just defining truth as well. They didn't find the real thought what actually truth means. Yes. I can say this is a speaker, I can explain this speaker, I can say what is within it, but I can't define truth. Somebody shall tell me what truth is.
Jesus!
And in the Hebrew alphabet,
Jesus.
Truth is made out of 3 letters, 28 letters in the Hebrew alphabet. The first, the 14th, and the 28th. Yes, the first, the one in the middle, which is 14, and number 28. That is the meaning of the word truth, the Bible says. According to the Hebrew alphabet. Why am I saying this? Because Jesus as well said that he's the way, the truth, and the life. Jesus said that he's the beginning and the end, ladies and gentlemen. Truth is something firm. The Bible does not define truth as only spiritual, but as something solid what you can hold on to.
Yes.
Yes, ladies and gentlemen. Truth has a name. Truth has a name which is everlasting.
Amen.
Truth has a name which was yesterday. And it's today, ladies and gentlemen, truth will be tomorrow.
Yes.
Truth is always available.
Yes, yes, yes.
Yes, in the word of life, there's truth.
Yes.
There's real truth, ladies and gentlemen.
Yes.
And truth is ready to welcome you home.
Yes.
And truth has a name, I'll say it again.
Yes.
And his name is Jesus.
Yes.
His name is Jesus, yes. From Jesus, from David, I think, to Jesus, it's 14 generations. Yes. Every 14 letter in the Hebrew alphabet. You count them together, you have truth, ladies and gentlemen. Jesus is forever.
Amen.
He is the truth forever.
Yes, yes, yes.
Apparently, when you take one letter away of truth in Hebrew, it becomes death, yes. If you take away from the truth, you will have death. You will not have life. But Jesus said, yes. He said, the God, Father, have given life to the Son. And the Son gives life to whomever it pleases him to give. That's why I say to you today, hold on to truth. And the truth is that Jesus Christ, Birmingham, came down from heaven in the likeness of the sinful man to die for the sins of the world.
Yes.
Jesus Christ died on the cross.
Yes.
I say it again, in a world in which man has no promise tomorrow, Jesus Christ died on the cross. Jesus died for the unworthy. Amen. He died for the sinners.
Yes.
He died for your life.
Yes.
He died for the life of your husband. He died forever who is in this world. That whosoever calls upon his name.
Yes.
Whosoever calls upon his name.
Jesus.
Whoever will seek him will find God, Jesus.
Hey.
Yes. I say it again.
Jesus.
Truth has a name, ladies and gentlemen. So when you next time a man says to you, I've told you the truth. No, truth is not the absence of a lie. Truth is the existence. Truth is a being. Truth, you can touch truth.
Amen.
And truth came to earth.
Yes.
And truth spoke truth. And truth went back to heaven.
Amen.
Only that you may come to heaven.
Amen.
And you may have truth. Yes.
Amen. Amen.
Yes, don't die in your sin, ladies and gentlemen. All sin is unrighteousness. Yes, the Bible says all sin is unrighteousness. And God is not a wicked God that he will let the unjust go. God is not a wicked God that he will not punish the ungodly. God is not a wicked God that he will let the whole world drown in their sin and living in wickedness and then take them to heaven and rejoice. Many people say to me they profess they're a good person, but the problem is there's no good people on earth. Yes, there's only sinners on earth. There's only sinners. There's not one good man on all the street. There's not one good man except of Jesus.
Amen.
Yes, and the only good man was ready to die for you, ladies and gentlemen. To die for the sins of the world. To die for the ungodly. To die for the wicked. To die for the just. Yes, Jesus died all in all that you may have life. Ladies and gentlemen, we are not standing here because there is nothing greater to do than to preach to you. But I need to say to you that there is a great possibility that on the street, most of the people, maybe in 100 years, possible, gonna be in hell. Yes, there's a great chance that many people will not wake up tomorrow morning. And they will have to stand a God who is angry. Yes, a God who's not pleased. A God who hates wickedness and who loves justice. The Bible says thy scepter is a scepter of righteousness.
Amen.
Yes, God hates sin, ladies and gentlemen. I will not hide the nature of God from you. I will not hide that God hates sin. God hates sin so much that he was ready to cast man into corruption. Yes, man was not meant to die, but he was ready to separate them, to cut them off from himself when they sinned. Yes, and because God hates sin so much, God even went further. He was ready, ladies and gentlemen, to give his own son on the cross on your behalf. Can you imagine throwing your baby, your son, your first begotten son, your only son, to the wicked to slay him? Can you imagine that, Birmingham? Can you imagine to die for the sinners? No man can do what Jesus did, yes. No man is able to bear what he bears. But you will reign with him? It's a question at the end of the day. It is a matter of choice. A matter of choice to receive Jesus. To take up your cross. To confess his name before man. To follow him into everlasting life. And to die in your sin. Yes! Don't die in your sin, ladies and gentlemen. You still have another chance. There's still another day. Tomorrow you may wake up. And if you wake up tomorrow morning, Birmingham, remember, it is not by your strength, it is not by your power, it is not by your moment, nor is it by anything, how much you got on your debit card. Yes, it is by the mercy of God, day by day. Don't go to hell, choose Jesus instead.